Hey guys, welcome to Pursue Kids Online. We are so excited that you're joining us today. I'm Miss Irene.
And I'm Miss Carrie, and it's my most favorite time of the week. It's time to worship. So get ready to stand to your feet, get ready to lift your hands and dance with us because worship starts now.
The house is so simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah. I don't gotta be afraid no more, no. Cause I know you up and through the storm. I'm more than just a talker. I'm a wave walker. I'm dancing on water. When the devil tries to shake me, I just pray harder. Even in my darkest hour, I got Holy Ghost power. When I keep my eyes upon you, Jesus, I'm a wave walker.
Shout out your praise. Let's join the house of the Lord. Our God is sure.
parade. 'Cause we were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. There's joy in the house.
There is joy in this house.
There's joy in the house of the Lord today.
Hey preschoolers, this week we get to learn about how God made us to help our friends. So get ready because your video starts right now.
Who? Who? You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go.
Do you know what this is? It's a dress-up box. I can have fun with all the different things inside. Do you know what this is? It's a pilot's helmet. Helicopter pilots wear these when they have to fly their helicopter to help people. If I were a pilot, I would fly this way and that way so I can help people everywhere. Ooh, this coat makes me look just like a doctor. If I were a doctor, I would use my stethoscope to listen to everyone's hearts, just like my doctor does. Hello, Mr. Bear. Your heart sounds very strong. Ooh, have you ever seen this before? It's a lifeguard whistle. Pool's open. If I were a lifeguard, I would practice my swimming every day so I'd always be ready to help people. I wish I could be a real pilot or a real lifeguard or a real doctor. Then I could help people all the time, just like they do.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie!
Hello, Zoe. Who? Who? Having fun with dress up, are you?
I am, Ollie. But I wish it wasn't pretend. That way I could really help people.
Those people are great helpers. It's true. But I know a way you can help too. Listen to this story. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through.
Oh, hola, friends. I'm Luis the Handyman. I'm just fixing this toy for my friends. They were having so much fun playing that the wheels started to come off. I love that I can use my tools to help my friends. That's the sign for help. Can you do it with me? Great job. Now raise your hand if you'd like to help your friends too. Oh, that's awesome. You can put your hands down now. Now, I have a great story to tell you about some friends who helped. If you want to help me build it, great. Let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres, hammer. Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down. Now, we just need our story tools. Yep, we have everything we need. Today's true story from the Bible begins with these four friends. These friends knew someone who needed help. His legs didn't work, and he couldn't walk. He needed their help because he had to be carried everywhere. One day, Jesus came to their town. Raise your hand if you know about Jesus. Wow, that's great! You can put your hands down now. There are so many amazing things to know about Jesus. Jesus is God's son. Jesus is an amazing teacher. And Jesus can do things only he can do. When people heard Jesus was in town, oh, they came running to see him. Whoa, that's a lot of people in one little house. They were all so excited to see Jesus. But they weren't the only ones excited to see Jesus. Do you remember the four friends? Well, when they heard that Jesus was in town, they were excited too. They knew Jesus could do amazing things. They knew Jesus could help their friend who couldn't walk. So, they helped him by picking him up and carrying him to Jesus. But when they got there, the house was full of people and they could not get in the front door. So, guess what they did? They carried their friend to the top of the house. Pretend you're climbing with me. Okay, we made it. Good job. Now they're on the roof. How are they gonna get their friend inside? They need to dig a hole in the roof. Everybody, dig a hole with me. The friends dug a hole in the roof and lowered their friend to Jesus. When Jesus saw how much the man and his friends believed that he could help, Jesus did something amazing. Jesus told the man to get up and walk. And he did! Jesus made the man's legs all better, and he could walk and even dance. That is amazing! Because the four friends helped the man who couldn't walk got to see Jesus, and Jesus helped him walk. Oh, wow! Those four friends did what God made them to do. They helped, and we can help too. God made you and me to help others. Hooray for helping! Hi, Ollie. Tell me, who made you to help others?
God made me to help others. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who made you to help others?
God made me to help others. That's the truth, friends. Adios.
So there's your story, and it's all true. God made us to help. That means me and you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, even though I'm not a real rescue pilot or real lifeguard or real doctor, I can still help others too. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. I have an idea. I could help my aunt by playing with my little cousins. And I could bring these costumes over so we can play dress up too. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hey guys, today in elementary, we're gonna talk all about how God sent the Holy Spirit to help us. So get ready because your video starts now.
All right. Brandon, do you have any more mayo? Hello everyone, I'm John.
And I am very much Brandon.
And this is the So-and-So Show.
The show where we, well, what do we do here exactly? Can you sum it up in one word?
Tomfoolery.
That's it.
Yeah, that's not all we do here, though. We also occasionally bring on educated people to teach us a thing or two about something we have no idea about.
Like today?
Yeah, like today. It's time for Someone Who Knows Stuff.
Hans!
Hello. Ah, who's the both of you?
Hello, come on in, have a seat, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so we know who you are, yeah. But for those in our audience who are new, could you tell us who you are and what you know?
Yeah, guten Tag, my name is Hans Decibel. I am an audio engineer and soundscape savant. I am fascinated with the smorgasbord of sounds that make up our world. I was recently contracted by a video game studio to gather potential sound effects for their new game they're calling Bird Village.
Ooh, Bird Village.
Yeah.
What's the game about?
It's about a bird that lives in a village. It's called Bird Village, Brandon. I think it's self-explanatory.
Yeah.
Hey, so is that why you've got all the, what are these? Oh, cassette players?
This is correct. For those who do not know, these are called cassette players. They play cassette tapes, physical media. You can use these to record sounds onto the actual tape and play sounds directly off of the tape. No internet required.
Ooh.
For example, this cassette is called Bird Sounds of North America.
Mm. Yeah.
Peaceful. When people think of video game sounds, many think of these prehistoric beeps and bloops from their forefathers like Galaga or Ooh. Mrs. Pac-Man.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Technology has advanced to the point where anything can be a video game sound.
Okay, what's the most interesting sound that you've gathered?
Well, name a thing. And I will see if I can play it for you.
Oh, okay. All right, I like this. Making a smoothie.
Yeah! Breakfast preparation. Mix number two. Yeah, okay. Pull that one out. Oh, it's on the B side. All right. There.
Wow. Okay, how about this? What about dropping a ball into a bowl of guacamole?
Ooh. Oh, yes. Friday night football watch party mishaps, number 13.
No kidding.
Yeah,
okay.
All right.
Here we go. Play.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, how about this one? A bear trapped on a hot air balloon with a marching band and a team of mimes.
No. Oh, the physics alone of this is impossible. The basket on a hot air balloon is too small to fit a bear and a marching band and a group of mimes, and the physical danger of a bear to other humans is just... this is not good.
Yeah.
But it does bring me to the point of why I've come here today. The climax of Bird Village features a surprise party. Now, normally I would just simply attend a surprise party, but the very definition of surprise party means I am unaware of them before they happen.
Right, surprise.
Yeah, surprise. So, I ask you, my friends, if you would be willing to help me by yelling surprise in various ways. I have tried to do this myself, but the results thus far have been uninspiring.
Surprise.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. Hans, we would be happy to help you.
Wunderbar.
Yeah.
Okay, one moment. Let me make sure I have the right tape in here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is on the correct side. It's important. Okay. All right, and record. Now, ready? Surprise me, and go!
Surprise!
Surprise!
Yes, now, as if you were unaware that you were at a surprise party, but everyone else is yelling it, so you need to as well, and...
Surprise!
Surprise!
Once more, but this time you think you should have brought a gift, but all you brought was a card. Ooh. Now, go!
Surprise!
Surprise!
Yeah, now one last time, but let's do a silly one.
Surprise!
Yeah.
Surprise!
Yeah, wunderbar. Now, how about all of you out there? Perfect!
Yeah.
Yeah, hey. Wunderbar.
Hey, glad we can help, Hans.
Yeah?
Any idea when we'll be able to hear this?
Right now.
What?
Surprise!
Yeah. Now that feels like a party I would love to attend.
Same here. Hey, thank you so much, Hans. Hey, do you want to stick around for the Bible story?
Of course! Seeing my friend Kellen would bring me so much delight.
Well, then you know what that means. It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hey, fellas. Oh, what's up, Hans?
Kellen, the joy it brings me to see your face is indescribable with words alone. The only way I can describe it is with this sound.
Hey, what are we getting into today, Kellen?
Well, today we're telling the story of what happened after Jesus ascended to heaven. And actually, Hans, as an expert on sound, do you think you could give us a hand with some of your sound jars?
Nothing would give me greater pleasure.
Great. So remember, Jesus died, and then in 3 days, he came back to life. He then spent 40 days with his friends and followers before he was taken back to heaven right before their eyes. But before Jesus left, he told his followers to wait for the gift God promised to send them. That gift was the Holy Spirit. Now, the people who believed in Jesus were all in Jerusalem for a day we call Pentecost. They were all gathered in the same room when suddenly the sound of a huge gust of wind filled the space. It sounded like a storm, but everything was calm outside. Then, in the room around them, they saw what appeared to be tongues of fire. What was that?
Ah, did you say tongues of fire?
Yes.
This is a tongue on fire. Yeah, here we are. Tongues of fire. Continue.
Thanks. The tongues of fire separated and came to rest on the people in the room. All the believers were filled with the Holy Spirit. They began to speak in languages they had not known before. The Spirit gave them the ability to know how to do this.
Konnichiwa. Hajimemashite. Dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
And stop. This wasn't something that just the people in the room experienced. Jewish people from all over the world were in Jerusalem for Pentecost, and they overheard what was happening. To some, it sounded like nonsense.
These people aren't even making sense.
But people from other nations were amazed. They knew the believers in Jesus weren't from their part of the world, and yet they could hear them speaking in their own language.
Incredible.
The believers needed someone to speak for them. So Peter, one of Jesus' disciples, stepped up to talk to everyone.
Everyone listen. We have seen Jesus do miracles through God's power. And though he was put to death, God raised him from the dead. So, be sure of this. God has made Jesus both Lord and Messiah.
The crowd was deeply affected by this. The people wanted to know what they should do. So Peter gave them very simple instructions.
All of you must turn away from your sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then your sins will be forgiven. You will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Sorry.
That day, 3,000 people became believers in Jesus, and they were baptized. A group of Jesus' followers were given the task to tell the whole world about him. On their own, this would have been impossible. They needed help, so God sent the Holy Spirit. When you put your trust in Jesus, the Holy Spirit is with you too, helping you in all kinds of ways. Thanks, Hans.
It's a pleasure for us all mine.
Yeah, thanks, Kellen. Great stuff.
Yeah, you really killed it today, Hans. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm an expert at sound. Mm-hmm. My collection is quite voluminous. Here, in fact, is a perfect example. Query disclosures.
Reveal the question.
Oh, wow. Wow, how specific.
Today's question is, when have you needed help?
Yeah. Mm. Oh, Hans, how about you?
Yeah. Well, this morning, I was trekking through the Amazon, attempting to capture the call of the subcontinental wind viper. It's a very elusive snake. I required a local guide to aid me. Now, after a few hours of trekking through the trees and the shrubs and the Amazon, we found the viper. He was instrumental in making sure I accomplished my mission.
So yeah, that or homework and stuff.
Yeah. You should never be afraid to ask for help, and when others ask, you should help them.
Just like the both of you did for me.
Oh. Yeah.
And like you did for me. And like I did for Kellen.
Yeah, and like we'll all try to do next week.
Yeah, and the week after. Yeah.
And so on.
Until then, I'm John.
I'm Brandon.
And I am Hans.
And this was...
Goodbye.
Like you're on a roller coaster.
Surprise!
Are you going down a hill on the roller coaster?
Surprise!
Now Brandon realizes John has a spider on his shoulder.
Surprise! Surprise! Surprise!
You turned on the baseball game, but instead you found the World Cup.
Surprise.
Now you're trying to fold a fitted sheet.
Surprise.
Surprise. You're trying to make a table out of toilet paper.
Oh, a surprise.
Now you're on a soap opera and you are revealing an old betrayal from 30 years ago.
Surprise.
Surprise.
Hey guys, I hope you had so much fun worshiping with us and that you learned something new from your Bible stories.
Yes, and don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any updates from Pursuit Kids Online. We love you guys and we'll see you next week.
Bye guys.